Hello. I am Professor Yu, and today on Technically You, we will be covering eavesdropping attacks. This is part one of a two-part series. What is an eavesdropping attack? These days there are a lot of people working from home, and from our friendly neighborhood coffee shop, this has allowed cybercriminals to step up and listen in on our digital communications. By using public, unsecured home networks or siphoning off your neighbor's Wi-Fi, we have let ourselves become vulnerable to an eavesdropping attack. So, what is an eavesdropping attack? Well, it is when someone tries to steal information transmitted through digital devices. Computers, smartphone, tablets, wearables, or other connected devices, to use for criminal purposes. The cybercriminal snags or intercepts sent and received data from unsafe or unsecured network communications between two parties. These attacks are difficult to detect as no abnormality can be detected during the network transmissions. This type of attack is also known as sniffing or snooping. Eavesdropping cybercriminals are always listening and can be located anywhere trying to get your sensitive personal information from vulnerable or unsecure website. Since we use the internet every day, our transaction is being spied upon. The cybercriminal is trying to sniff out what we share every time we make a purchase, view our bank accounts or investments, use social media, sign up for an app, register for schools, schedule an appointment, or apply for a loan. Keep in mind, our connected devices are also loaded with our contacts, photos, videos, location and health and financial data. Cybercriminal may use this information against you. How do they listen in on your communication? Cybercriminals use special programs developed to seek out and record parts of sensitive data communications from unsecure networks. The recorded and captured data packets that are then analyzed using advanced cryptographic tools, or they simply read the obtained data or listen to the conversation, in hopes of capturing valuable information. Cybercriminal also place malware in apps for you to load on your phone, or from website you visit using your laptop or tablet, that allows them to remotely activate your microphone or camera to record your conversations. For you iPhone users, Apple recently added a new feature that display an orange dot when the audio or camera goes live, making you aware that your phone is in the listening and recording mode. What will they do with your information? There are many things that cybercriminals can do with your stolen information. Here are a couple of items. Financial harm, using your bank account information to make unauthorized purchases or to transfer money to their account. Steal your identity, using your personal address, social security number, account, or credit card information and other details to impersonate you. The information is then used to commit crimes and lay the blame on the victim. Blackmail, using incriminating evidence gathered from text messages, photos or videos, cybercriminals can use what they obtained against you, a friend, or a loved one, for financial gain or emotional leverage. Security breaches, using stolen passwords, cybercriminals can gain access to private or corporate networks. Selling your information, some cybercriminals will sell any private or sensitive information they have on you, making them a quick and easy profit. This is our technical brief for today. Thank you for watching. Part 2 of our series will cover how to protect yourself. If you found this topic interesting, please hit the subscribe button now.